Hi guys, it's Jess and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I bet you're wondering why I've got my head in a hair wrap. If you haven't already guessed from the title of this video, we are dyeing hair today. And I'm really excited to show you guys how it went. So, like I said in the previous video, I do have a week off in lockdown with lots of plans to do crazy things or just like stuff to make me feel better in my space or in myself, mind, body, whatever. My hair needed doing for a while. It had like 5 different colours in it. It had natural, it had purple, I still had bits of ginger in it, and I just needed it sorting out. And I've always done my hair myself, and I thought it would be a good opportunity to get it done and to film it for you guys to see how it went. And if you haven't already seen from the thumbnail what colour I'm dyeing my hair, it would be this ginger. I have been ginger before, it has been a while, and I have been saying for a while, oh yeah, I'll grow my natural hair back out, and it's never happened. So I figured let's go back ginger for the summer, it's nice in the sun. Anyways, so next you'll see the process of me getting this done. My t-shirt will change, and but yeah, please enjoy, and I'll see you guys in a minute. So, yesterday, dyeing our hair, and I've done this many a time. I've always dyed my hair at home. I don't think I've ever got it professionally done, which isn't a bad thing. But yeah, I quite like doing my own hair, dyeing it crazy colours. In the past, I have done a few colours, but because my hair is so dark, thanks to my mum, who literally has jet black hair, I've never really been able to dye any, like, you know, pastely colours or, like, neon colours. I think the most I ever got was in high school. I did dye my hair bright red, but still, it just looked like a really weird brown colour with bits of red in it. So I've never really had, like, a full-on electric bright colour. Actually, I do tell a lie. I did bleach my hair once, and it went weird gingery blonde. Obviously, I did not do it right. I got my sister to do it. And that was the last time I decided to bleach my hair. So I've never really bothered with having, you know, the bleached hair and then putting a colour on it. The one colour that's always really stuck and looked quite nice on me, and I haven't had it for a few years, was ginger. So this is what we're working with today. So yeah, I'm dyeing my hair today bright ginger. Hopefully, it will take. I know it's not going to come out like the on the box, but yeah, this is what I'm using. I'm using Live Intense Colour in Mango Twist. And as like I say, I know it's not going to come out like this on my hair, but it'd just be nice to have a little bit of a change. So I've got my equipment here. I've got a bowl, I've got a little brush thing, and we have some gloves. To be honest, I never usually use a bowl or the brush thing, I just kind of use my hands, but I thought, let's get a bit technical today. Let's make it look at least like we're being professional. Might just mix it up first. So, I was gonna do this in my bathroom, which is probably the smarter idea, but in my bathroom there's a, like an extractor fan, and there's no way I can turn it off, and that's all you'd hear in the background of the video. So I decided to do the very unsmart thing and do it in my room, which is going to smell of hair dye later, so I apologise to Tom. Oh, that is bright. That is orange. Oh my god. This is the colour we got at the moment. Just going to mix that in. I feel professional. I feel like one of those YouTubers who does the hair on YouTube regularly. That is the colour. Can you see? That is the colour I'm going to be, well, hopefully, fingers crossed. I'm excited. Actually, I'm just going to go get a towel, maybe put it on the floor, because that would be a good idea. So I have put a big towel down on the floor. I usually would put a towel around my shoulders, but I'm not really bothered about this top. I love this top though. It's got little cactuses on it. If you've seen my Instagram, I'm the crazy plant lady. But yeah, probably should put on some gloves. That would be a smart idea too. And I don't know. I might keep my glasses on just so I can do see what I'm doing for now. But they'll probably end up coming off, if I'm quite honest. Yo, yo. I always really start by getting my roots. I was trying to think of a way to do it. You know how, especially when you've got a brighter colour, but you want to make it look a bit more natural, or more natural, if that's the word for it, but where you have natural roots, but then you've got this really bright colour. I was trying to figure out a way to do that. But knowing me, it would just be like a horrible line of dark roots and then just this weird colour. So I just think I'd do it the way I normally do. Just get all of those roots, all the baby hairs. The baby hairs on me especially, we've got quite blonde ones. I don't know if you can, well, you won't be able to see. We've got quite bright blonde baby hairs. So when we dye it any kind of colour, it takes to that so well. And those are the brightest bits. Told you the glasses will be coming off. It's just not worth it. Thinking also this might be a better way to do it. Obviously, this is probably why hairdressers do it. It's because you're wasting less. Because in the bottle, when you think about it, you've got loads and loads of probably hair products left over in that bottle. And I know when I get towards the end of it, I'm just putting it anywhere. So I'm probably putting it in places that don't need it. So I don't think it's as even. I don't know. I'm not a hairdresser or a professional hair dye expert. So correct me if I'm wrong. This seems to be going well so far. Less mess on the gloves. So this whole thing, again, whole thing about this week. Like I said, yesterday I posted a video on, you know, like, of cleaning my room, basically. And it may just seem like a silly little video. Maybe a little boring video. But what I wanted to do this week was, you know, just get myself in order. So get my house in order, get this, because I know, well, I think if you have a nice clean space, then your mind just feels a lot better. And I know as soon as I cleaned my space, my room, like in the last couple of days, with it being like this, it's just been so much nicer. I just coming in here and feeling it's a place to come relax rather than coming in, seeing all the mess that's on the floor, having to walk around things. Tom's especially liking it because usually he sleeps on the other side of the bed towards the wall. So when he comes to bed, he has to climb over all my rubbish, all my stuff. I don't know how he puts up with me sometimes, bless him. But he's a good egg. But yeah, I just wanted a clean space. And then I wanted to start on myself. So this is an idea I've wanted to have for a while. I haven't dyed my hair in quite a long time. The last time I dyed it, like I mentioned in another video, it was bright purple, and that was not my intention. I was actually planning on keeping it quite natural because I like my natural hair colour, but I haven't been my natural hair colour in, I'd say, about a decade. Because I dyed my hair, started really from the end of high school, so year 10, 11, I dyed it bright red, and I've never really looked back. So I wanted to sort my space out, and then I wanted to sort myself out. So again, my parents, I'm not overly bothered, like, it sounds weird, but I've never really been bothered about doing the makeup every day. I've not been about getting up at 5 a.m. every morning. I mean, that is commitment to all the ladies out there that decide to do it. I applaud you, but I've never been that kind of person. I would rather sleep a few more hours than look amazing. And it shows, but it's not a bad thing. I don't know. I've just never really been bothered about the whole makeup every day. Obviously, I wear the clothes I want to wear. I'm never really bothered what people think. I like wearing weirder out there clothes when I do make an effort. I like wearing alternative things, shall we say. And I just do my thing. And if I do dye my hair, I dye it crazy colours. I've never really been about, you know, highlights or ombre or, I don't know. I don't even know the correct terms, but, you know, I don't know what I'm trying to say. I'm not bitching about people that do. It's amazing for people that do. I commend you, I applaud you, because I wish I was that kind of person sometimes that put the effort in to look so amazing every day and put that makeup on every day and But it's just not me. I mean, I'll be honest with you guys. I haven't shaved my legs in about 4 months. And that's a regular thing. And there's a few different factors. It's like, overall, it doesn't really bother me whether I do look a certain way or not. Obviously, I want to look nice, but the way I think of it is, if you want to make yourself look nice, the reason you're doing it is to make yourself feel more confident in yourself, make yourself feel good, and that's why you should be doing it. And I go through a thing of, well, I'm not doing this for the outside world, because I don't honestly care what they think. I've walked out in some strange outfits, some weird hair colours, some overly bright makeup, I've had heads turn, but it doesn't matter to me. I mean, it's for me, it's not for them, and I know some people put the effort in for the benefit of a partner or a loved one, and again, that's not bad. I mean, sometimes I like, when we did go out, it's nice to put like a bit of makeup and look nice for your significant other, but I don't do this for Tom. I love him, but I know he loves me exactly the way I am. He's seen me through my best and my worst. I mean, we've lived together for over 2 years now, and he's seen me at my very worst. He's seen me in full Wookiee Chewbacca mode, and he doesn't care. And even though, and I know he doesn't care, but every day I'm still like, oh, I look ugly, I'm so hairy, I haven't washed my hair in 3 days, and he's just like, you're still you, he still cares. So I know I don't have to make myself look a certain way for someone else or for the rest of the world. So if I do something like this, like dye my hair or spend hours and hours putting makeup, I'm doing it for me. And that's the way I think it should be. But what do I know? This is just my life experience, how I see things. I'm not saying it's right or wrong. I don't know. You might have a completely different opinion to me, and that's fine. But if you're going to do something, do it for yourself. Do it to make yourself happy, because that's all that really matters in the end, I think. Yes, but now we've rambled on. I think I've got all my roots. I think. Say that. I'm working blind here, but I'm used to it. I do my makeup with no glasses on, and I've done that ever since I started doing makeup. And sometimes it's worked out really well, and sometimes it hasn't. But you win some, you lose some. I think one of the first times I dyed my hair, it was towards the end of high school, about year 10, 11. I was a really late bloomer with anything like that, with makeup or anything. Like, all the girls in the bathroom, you'd see a break time, you'd be applying makeup, spraying the hair, putting the sprays on. And I never really got into that until the end of school. I don't know. But yeah, I remember dyeing the hair red. And it seemed like a bright red, but it didn't come out too much. But I was kind of going through, if anybody out there knows, where's my emo kids? You go through the emo kiddie phase of backcombed hair and winged eyeliner and scarves in hair. I liked wearing headscarves. Well, not like big headscarves, but like a really thin one. You could just tie around your head into a bow. I loved doing that. Although there was a few times where I got told to take it out because it wasn't appropriate for school. Thank you. just gonna say now. I know it looks like I'm going orange everywhere, but that's my process. So at the end of this, I'm gonna wipe all the orange off, like, with my forehead, tops of my ears. I'm gonna get it all out the way. But I'm quite sure I probably am gonna end up with orange ears for the next week or so, but I'm fine with that. Definitely think I've got all the roots now. Anyway, the roots that you can see are starting to resemble a Weasley from the Harry Potter series, which I have been actually reading recently. I've never read them before. Can I hear all of you screaming in the background? I've never read Harry Potter before, but I'm starting to read them now and I am in love with them. But yeah, I'm starting to think I look like a Weasley, which isn't a bad thing. Yeah, so probably just end up skipping through the next little bit. Just to get the rest of it done, the length of the hair done. I might end up ditching the brush just to get my hands in, because that's the way I usually do it. Dye left over, guys. Like, I've got quite thick hair, courtesy of my mum again, thank you. I've got quite thick hair, and whenever I've dyed it, from being quite young, I've always needed two boxes, always. I have two boxes. But looking at it now, I've done all the roots, and I think I've got pretty much most of the length covered. And I've still got quite a lot of the tin of the tub left. So I guess it maybe does go to show, if you maybe use the brush, you are using less, so maybe I won't have to buy two boxes of hair dye in the future. But I think I will. I mean, that's always for next time, because I always do another dye my hair. This could be like a bi-monthly thing, because if we're in this for a while, I'm going to have to be dyeing my hair a bit more often. Guys, if this goes terribly wrong, I could end up on one of those YouTube channels that shows people doing their hair badly, and I love watching those. I'd love to be on one of those YouTube channels, so if this goes wrong, I'm sending it through to one of you guys. You can review my bad hair. But yeah, just realizing how orange these gloves look, how orange my face and ears look, and I'm just praying that I'll get to it in time with the baby wipe. Yep, I've got an orange all over this top, just on the shoulders. Oh, I'm gonna keep it though. I think it's gonna be my hair dye and t-shirt. Maybe like the more colours I use, the more colourful it'll become. It could be like a tie-dye t-shirt kind of thing. Oh my god. Have you seen the back of my neck? Oh my god. It's orange. I'm orange. Right. I'm done. I've used the whole pot when I probably shouldn't have done it, but I should have just left it at what it was. But yeah. So says to leave it on for 20 to 30 minutes. I usually leave it on for a bit longer, but if you're doing this at home, read the instructions and stick with the instructions. If it starts burning, you know, wash it off. Me personally, just from years of hair dyeing, I always leave it on a bit longer because I know my hair can be quite stubborn with the colour. But yeah, I'm just going to go to the bathroom and wipe off all this excess off my ears, off my face. And hopefully I won't resemble a tangerine in a second. I'll be back in a minute. Oops, sorry. Hey, so we're back. Managed to get a lot of the orange off. I can't see much of the back. I've had to have Tom to scrub it with a baby wipe. Hopefully it's come off. If not, maybe I've just given myself a slight tan. Or I look like an Oompa Loompa. Anyways, so 20 to 30 minutes with this on. So, what can we do for 20 to 30 minutes? Sure how long it's been because I've got a bit distracted with my laptop and doing a bit of editing, so it might have been over half an hour, but I still have hair. I don't know if you can see the roots underneath. Definitely have gotten lighter, but yeah, I am going to dry this and we'll see what it looks like in a minute, and then I'll show you guys. Wish me luck. So, I know I said I was going to do the foam reveal in a minute, but I've just taken out the hair wrap. And I love it. It's bright ginger. It will look so much brighter on camera. It doesn't look as bright, but oh my gosh, it's bright ginger, my roots. Oh my god, I love it. I love it already. It's not even dry, but I love it. Oh, and I also had to change my t-shirt because I managed to drown myself in the shower trying to rinse this out. And also, we have a puppy in the background. Can you see my cat? She's lovely and so sweet. Anyway, right, okay, back to it. I will go and rinse this out and then we'll do the final reveal. I'm so excited. Hi again. So I hope you enjoyed that. You got a few laughs from me dancing around, singing. Hopefully I'm not going to get copyrighted, but we'll see. Anyways, the moment you've all been waiting for, it is pretty much dry. I think I might have left some bits wet because I have no patience, but you'll just see. What do we think? Oh my gosh. It looks so bright on camera. It looks so much better. So in person, it looks nice, but if you look on there, it's bright orange and that is exactly what I wanted. I don't think it's as severe off camera as it is on camera, but either way, I'm really happy. What do you guys think? Oh, I feel so much better already. So thank you so, so much for watching this video. And if you did like it, please give this video a like. And if you want to see more, please subscribe to my channel. Or if you want to catch up with me on Instagram, Twitter and Facebook, I'll leave the links for those down below. If you want to look at any of my other videos, I'm sure there's a link somewhere to one of them. But yeah, if you want to keep up with my week off, please do. And again, hope you're all well. Okay, I hope this is helping, keeping you entertained and giving a little bit of happiness to your day. But until next time, I love you guys so, so much, and I'll see you again soon. Bye!